Together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome everyone to the 33rd Sunday of Ordinary Time. This is the last Sunday of liturgical year, because next Sunday is the Sunday of Christ the King. And Jesus speaking about the end of time, and at the end of time is no one know, but we always waiting for God coming to us in every single time of our lives. Maybe through the one we know, maybe through what happening around us, and God always speaking to us. My name is Father Nyang Lee, and Father Thomas Torescu, and Deacon Marius, and a reader today, Sister Grace Villas. Coming together as God's family, we ask God to strengthen us with His love and forgiveness as we prepare for His coming into our lives. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to the people of good will. We praise you. We bless you.
We adore you.
We glorify you.
We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father,
you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
You take away the sins of the world,
receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father,
have mercy on us.
For you alone are the Holy One,
you alone are the Lord.
You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit,
in the glory of God the Father.
Amen. Let us pray from the silence of our hearts. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, the constant gladness of being devoted to you. For it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the prophet Daniel. At that time, Michael will stand up, the great prince who mounts guard over your people. There is going to be a time of great distress and paralyzed since nations first came into existence. When that time comes, your own people will be spared, all those whose names are found written in the book of you who lie sleeping in the dust of the earth. Many will awake, some to everlasting life, some to shame and everlasting disgrace. The learned will shine as brightly as the vault of heaven, and those who have instructed many in virtue as bright as stars for all eternity. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
O Lord, it is you who are my portion and cup. It is you yourself who are my prize. I keep the Lord ever in my sight. Since he is at my right hand, I shall stand firm.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
And so my heart rejoices, my soul is glad, even my body shall rest in safety, for you will not leave my soul among the dead, nor let your beloved know decay.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
You will show me the path of life, the fullness of joy in your presence, at your right hand, happiness forever.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. All the priests stand at their duties every day, offering over and over again the same sacrifices, which are quite incapable of taking sins away. Christ, on the other hand, has offered one single sacrifice for sins, and then taken his place forever. At the right hand of God, where he is now waiting until his enemies are made into a footstool for him. By virtue of that one single offering, he has achieved the eternal perfection of all whom he is sanctifying. When all sins had been forgiven, there can be no more sins offerings. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please all stand to welcome the gospel.
Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
May the Lord open your heart and mind to proclaim the good news. May God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, and the sons of man.
Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, in those days after the time of distress, the sun will be darkened, the moon will lose its brightness, the stars will come falling from heaven, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken. And then they will see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great power and glory. Then too, he will send the angels to gather his chosen from the four winds, from the ends of the world to the ends of heaven. Take the fig tree as a parable. As soon as its wigs grow supple and its leaves come out, you know that summer is near. So with you, when you see these things happening, know that he is near, at the very gates. I tell you solemnly, before this generation has passed away, all these things will have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But as for that day or hour, nobody knows it, neither the angels of heaven nor the Son, no one but the Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, we are living in a world of constantly changing. We hear sometimes climate change, education system, or political system. On and on, there is a lot of changes taking place. Maybe a small example, like in the homes, when someone, your loved ones, goes out, you know, mobile is given so that to keep in touch. So in the world of technology, even the whole system is completely getting changed. According to the research, it says that in the year of 2000, there were 740 mobile subscriptions people were there. But after the two decades, 2020, as the research says, it has gone up to 8 billion people have subscribed to mobile phone. That means it is more than the world population. Our world population is 7.9 billion. So it also shows about how much the major sector of the life of people had changed. So having looked at all these constant changes in this life of ours, today the scripture is talking about heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away. What is this passing away? Yes, it is true. For every individual, the world of heaven and earth is passing away. Just take an example, when someone is born, someone dies. Or someone is fulfill the succession, or someone fails. So like in the world of change, there are a lot of things happening. Well, when the scripture is referred into this context, remember we need to know the context of the people during those days. Probably the scripture might have written in 70 AD. We are also reminded about the destroying of Jerusalem. And the people of Jewish temple was the center of faith and life. So destroying of the city of Jerusalem and
robbing of the temple could have been a great disaster for those people. They could feel that the end of the time has come. So it also speaks about the apocalyptic literature, that means explaining about the end time. Well, Jesus speaks about, tells to his disciples, the sun will be darkened, the moon will loosen its brightness, the stars will be falling off, and the powers of heaven will be shaken. And I'm sure people of Jewish were so much shaken by all these distractions. For the people of Jewish, it was very suitable in their explanation. Distraction is something we also experience in different ways. We come across like there are failures in our life. We come across there are dark days. We also comes across like there are moments of good times and bad times. So in our life, we experience different types of our life, different types of our own experiences. So in our small world, the scripture is so suitable for us. But when Jesus says, my words will not pass away, this gives us a great hope amidst of all obstacles we come across. There is a great hope. And what does it mean by this, my words? It's the words of God, the incarnated word of God into the life of Jesus. The word that is eternal. And this word, Jesus tells to his disciples, have faith in Christ. Be born and renewed, and be born again in the Spirit of God. Be renewed. And as we all of us have experienced in during the baptism, we are renewed. We are incorporated into the life of Christ. When we have faith in God, when we believe into the Word of God, the very Word that we embrace will give us an opportunity to have eternal life. We experience about here on earth and life after. When Jesus assures us about the eternal Word, the Word, the transformation, the transforming Word, when we participate, the Word of God will transform into our life. That's why where Jesus says, my words will not pass away. In the kingdom of God, we come across the first will be last, the lost will be found, the least will be the greatest. It's Jesus, it's God who makes us great. The basis of Jesus' teaching on us is that God's unconditional love for us, giving us a great hope in the midst of tribulation. In the midst of our discouragement, Jesus gave us a great hope, hope in God. And that's the beautiful passage Jesus is trying to enlighten us. The Son of God will come in power and in glory. That also metaphorically speaking about the angelic, the angel, the angel Michael, who will be saving us if we only listen to him. The Spirit of God will give us a protection. We are only asked to have faith in God. In faith, we all of us will be redeemed. May God bless each one of us and pray each day that we may be able to constantly have faith in our life in the midst of our difficulties, in the midst of our tribulation. God bless each one of us.
Let us please stand and profess our faith in the God of love, the God of life, the God who saves. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before ages. God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, alert to our needs and the needs of the world, let us bring out prayers before the God of all.
That the Church entrusted with God's kingdom on earth will work with creativity and zeal. Hear us, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations and global corporations will use the earth's resources responsibly. Hear us, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That men and women will treat each other with dignity and respect. Hear us, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who use their gifts and talents for others will be abundantly blessed. Hear us, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the children receiving the Eucharist for the first time, may their joy and love increase as they journey in faith. Hear us, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead will be rewarded for their goodness, including the recently deceased Giovanni Corso, Maria Del Rey, Matilda Vitaglioni, Rita Molan, Camelia Allen, Nelson Maggi, Bernadette Ogwo, Tran Banton, Nguyen Tien, Jolie Casaselli, Pasqualino Di Gennaro, Jerry Lenz, Maria Pellegrini, Francisco Talia, Patsy Smith, and those whose names are recorded in the Book of Remembrance at St. Martin and St. John Bosco Church, hear us, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Generous God, you lavish us with gifts so that we may work for the coming of your reign. Hear these prayers and help us to remain faithful to your word. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to offer. which earth has given and human hands have made, will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and works of human hands will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, dear friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the grace and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you, and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. And by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angel and archangel, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as with our end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy,
holy Lord, God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, that they might become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread through all the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis the Pope and Peter Comensoli, your Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also your servants, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also brothers and sisters, especially mentioned in the memorial book, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence to God, our loving Father, in the words our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Father, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
We pray for peace. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your disciples, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We pray that may the body and the blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Act of spiritual communion.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you.
Never permit me to be separated from you.
Amen.
Let us continue to pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God. And thank you, everyone.